Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with a bit of an old, brand new Let's Play. This time it's of Aviary Attorney on that there PC. Yes, this is just being released to essentially replace the STALKER Shadow of Chernobyl Let's Play for the simple reason that he had a word with the chap whose Patreon donation was paying for the STALKER Let's Play and convinced him to let me drop that Let's Play, because I'm not going to say that STALKER Shadow of Chernobyl is a bad game. I just don't enjoy it. It was very annoying. It was just frustrating and boring for me. But this is probably going up before the last episode of Stalker. Yeah, I'm just going to call it Stalker. Goes up. I recorded up to episode 11, so there might be a couple of episodes left when you're watching this, or maybe they're all up already. I don't know. But yeah, so in place of STALKER, I'm playing Aviary Attorney. Now, if you don't know what Aviary Attorney is, Aviary Attorney is a game that I believe is best described as being essentially... It's kind of, it's very heavily inspired by the Ace Attorney games, the Nintendo Ace Attorney games, or the Nintendo, the ones that almost all, I don't think they're made by Nintendo, I think they're made by Capcom, but they're on Nintendo handhelds, those games, except it's in 19th century France, and all the people are animal people. Yeah, that's what this game is. It's been a while since I've played it. I did play it briefly. Well, briefly. I completed the fucking thing. Back when it came out. However, it has multiple endings, and it's been a while, so I can't actually remember how you solve the various trials. And I was shit at it. So, hey, here's hoping I do better this time. Right, new game. Also, I believe it has no... voice acting. So, are you ready for some stupid voices? Because I'm going to be trying to do stupid voices. January 1st, 1848. Oh, the Chateau... Oh, fuck. The Chateau Crenet... That place? This is going well. Oh God. Is that Monsieur Grandwee? Oh, mon dieu! I don't know who's actually saying that. Dame Cataline, what have you done? Who is that? Who's saying this? I can't give something a voice if I don't know who's saying it. The cat with claws. Or a cat with claws. Ah, one of our two main characters here. There's kind of a Sherlock, Sparrow, Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson vibe kind of going on. Also, just going to quickly point out, this guy is one of the creepiest looking characters in the game. Tell you why. Bird head, human hands. That's really weird. You know what I mean? I can't remember if everyone else looks like that, but that's kind of creepy. Anyway, it's midday already. Where on earth is that feather head? Oh my God, he looks like he's got mutton chops.
Well, well, well. Look who finally decided to get up. Haven't you heard what they say about the early bird, Falcon?
Okay, you know what? This is just gonna be me. Because, you know, this is my character. It's too early for worms. Past fuck. It's, Cabernet. Fuck knows, the cabinet.
But time for that later. We've got some business to handle first.
Business?
A letter arrived while you were sleeping. I haven't opened it yet. Yet. It's probably just more junk mail. Go ahead, Sparrowson. You may have the honors. All right. Dear Monsieur Falcon, I'm writing to you today because my daughter, Dame Cataline, has been arrested for a crime she did not commit. She's being held at La Concierge...
Okay, that's not concierge. Conciergerie? That's gotta be conciergerie, hasn't it?
Prison on the charge of murder, no less. Her trial's in 3 days' time. I'd be greatly in your debt if you would offer her legal aid. Yours sincerely, Seigneur...
French. That's gotta be a pun, and if I recall correctly, the guy's a cat. Poirot. It can't be Poirot, can it? I don't know. Poirot de Meow. There we go. Poirot de Meow. I don't care. It's probably wrong. It's French. Why did I... What? Why am I doing a game that I have to read dialogue out and half the dialogue's French names? Jesus fucking Christ.
Well, this is quite something. I know... Oh, wait. No. I did Sparson's voice. I know. Your first series client in months. Not just that, the Demiour estate is well known for its exuberant wealth. Even if we cannot do much for Dame Catiline, his lordship would still reward us handsomely for our efforts. You greedy fucker. You're man after my heart. Well, I suppose you intend on defending Dame Catiline in court? Nope! Think not, Sparrison. The fate of a fat cat bourgeoisie, see I know how I pronounce that, bourgeoisie is none of my concern. Pass the cabinet. Already. What? With all respect, Falcon, we've been doing nothing for the past 2 weeks. Anything would be better than another day of thumb twiddling, which you shouldn't have! Still, come on, let's be productive members of society. You can't opt out of the game this early? What's wrong with you? No. No, I've made up my mind. Okay, fine. Can we at least play some cards to pass the time? Now there's a marvelous game. What game? We don't really have enough players for Tap Tarok or... Sigo? Kego? Don't know. I know. There's this game I learned at university called Jacques Noir. Jacques Noir? That sounds dubious. No, it's a real game. Let me tell you how it works. You draw cards from this deck to get as close to 21 as possible without going over... Oh. Call hit if you want to knock... Yeah. You are aiming to get as close to 21 without going over. Sounds good. Deal me. Wait, are we actually just... Okay, well, I mean, I knew this was a mini-game in the game, but... Hit me. I win, fuck you. What do you think? Are you getting the gist of it? Yeah, I think I've got it. Alright, now we can make this interesting. How do you feel about a little wager? Sorry, I'm slowly turning Sparrison into fucking Melchett. Sounds good, what do you have in mind? 1 franc per round? 2? So they're all animals, but they still use francs. Odd. No, I think it's something else. I'm intrigued, go on. You play 1 round, if I win, you have to take on Dame Catiline's case. You know what, I'm impressed the game has actually gone this far. I mean, the game's gonna put us on the plot railroad, that's fine, that's... The game needs us to take this case in order to continue the fucking game, you know what I mean? But I'm quite impressed about how far this game is willing to go. I didn't do this when I played it originally, I'm gonna be deliberately unhelpful in every dialogue choice, just saying. But yeah, this game's actually going to quite a length to give us a reason to get on the case when we don't want to. Sounds like a hefty wager. What do I get if I win? If you win... I've got it! If I win, you must... Go on a diet. No chocolate, pastries, or cakes for 1 month. That makes more sense if you know this character is a greedy fucking gannet. Why? What could you possibly get out of me going on a diet? Absolutely nothing, but will it be immensely satisfying to watch you writhe in hunger as you munch on celery sticks and carrots? It's one of the reasons I enjoyed this game so much. It's got quite funny writing. Despite the art style, the art style makes it look incredibly pretentious, but it's just pretty funny. It's very comedic, just it has some dark turns in it. And so, you're a cruel bird, Falcon, but we have a deal. Pass me the deck.
Can we win?
Hit me. Shit! Damn it. Well, it looks like I won. How about that?
What? No way, you cheated. You didn't shuffle those cards properly. Let's go again, 2 out of 3.
How does the American proverb go, Falcon? Don't hate the player, hate the game. I do think that proverb doesn't actually appear for quite some time.
Also, yes, I know this voice. Any of you who've played the game will be saying, that voice seems wildly inappropriate for this character. Yes, I know, it's great.
This is my punishment for gambling on a made-up card game, isn't it?
Okay, I do know that that's an actual card game and I've played it before, but for some reason the name of it's escaping me. No, it's not. It's blackjack. Jacques Noir. I'm an idiot. I'm a fucking idiot. Took me like 3 minutes to realize Jacques Noir is blackjack. Fine, we'll take the case.
Excellent, my derriere.
Of course, derriere is one of the few words in French I know how to pronounce.
My derriere was getting tired from all this sitting around.
I know how to pronounce derriere because I'm a child. Unrelated, I studied Spanish when I was in secondary school. Didn't have a choice, they made me do it. And I can only remember, aside from like the standard shit that everyone knows, like hola and si, I can only remember two words in Spanish. Silence and cathedral. And that's just because it's silencio and catedral. And I fucking love... This might be a bit too much information, but at one point when I was with one of my ex-girlfriends, obviously she wasn't my ex-girlfriend at the time, things were getting a bit intimate. I used to get right up near her ear and then just immediately ruin it by just going,
silencio, catedral.
Fully understand why she left me now. Right, anyways. Shit like that is why I'm gonna die single. But damn it, I laughed before then.
Oh, but I better file away Senor Demial's first letter. One moment, Falcon.
You know what? Do I have a pen on hand? I've got half mind to write down the like phonetically how I'm pronouncing these fuckers' names because I will not remember. Poirot. I'm just gonna call him Poirot because I don't know how else to pronounce his name. Feel free to correct me in the comments. I may not see it by the time I record another video, by the time it stops being relevant, but it'll help. You may access the evidence roll at any time by clicking the suitcase. Oh, it is at any time. Okay. Oh, I nearly forgot my wallet. Wouldn't want to lose that.
Again, I recall you losing it at the New Year's party. And at Christmas.
Yes, alright. No need to make a list. Picked up the wallet, in which we have money, which comes into it at some point. See how much money he's carrying. Yep. Let's make a move. Welcome to the map screen. I mean, you can travel any listed areas. Mark with a clock symbol. Take a whole day. Okay, so far we have two areas. My office, which we just came from, and... Conciergerie? The conciergerie? The conciergerie. Whatever. I'm taking a guess. I'm having a guess at French. I'm hoping if I do it in a bit of a French accent, it'll make it sound more believable.
Falcon and Sparrison step into the stone-cold foyer of the conciergerie prison. Sullen-faced guards and visitors linger beneath the medieval archways. Ah, the conciergerie. They say this is the finest prison in the whole of France! Gay Paris! The outer walls are impenetrable, the cells are spotless, the guards are well-mannered.
Quark. Ah, I love this guy.
Good day, monsieur. I'm here to see Dame Catalin Demiar. I'm due to represent her in court.
What voice should I give this guy? I realize I didn't do one of his... You know what? He's an old fucking... I think he's supposed to be a jackdaw. Really old, really honor.
Oh!
No.
Ah! You're her lawyer, eh? Fine,
It's like the penguin.
Wah, wah. Fine, fine, follow me! Well, what are you waiting for? Come on! Ah!
The voices get annoying, do tell me. Also, I'm just reading out female characters in as bland a voice as possible, because I cannot do a female voice.
Sigh. My papa hasn't forgotten about me, has he? Dame Catalin de Miau, I presume? You've arrived. The fantastic lawyer, Monsieur Falcon. And his...
Is that petite? No, there's not an E on the end. Fuck knows, I'm gonna say petite, even though he's not. Petite assistant, Sparrowson.
The lady is knowledgeable.
Don't talk like that, Sparrowson.
Sorry. My papa told me that he would only hire the best lawyers in town. I'm flattered. But they weren't available at such short notice, so he hired the first people in the address directory. Oh. You see, Falcon, I told you listing under Aviary Attorney would pay off. Let's get down to business. Dame Cataline, could you fill us in on some details? Your father's letter was a little brief.
I can do my best. What is it you wanted to know?
And now we get to ask some questions. Did you see anything suspicious?
Suspicious?
Like, you know, a guy hiding in the shadows. Maybe a blood-soaked murder weapon?
Monsieur Falcon, I do believe you are looking for an easy answer.
Okay, let's be honest. If I could get an easy answer, I'd take an easy answer. Do you know what I mean?
You got me, but I would take an easy answer if one was offered. I did not see anything, I am afraid. The evening was very normal, the food was delicious, the conversation was boring. It was all very ordinary until the incident.
I see! Wait, Falcon, you missed something of huge importance!
Okay.
Dame Cataline, you said the food was delicious. But you didn't say what food it was!
Ah, you fucking twat. You
and your damn stomach.
Let me see. We had poached red hair.
It's a red herring.
To start, garnished with garlic butter. The wrong way sign. Go on.
Then a marbled steak, served perfect bloody rare.
It's a raw steak. Glorious! Falcon, write this down.
What? This cannot possibly be relevant to the case.
Write it all down, please. For me.
Fine, fine. The red herring has been added to your evidence folder. No game about detectives can help itself. If it's got a comedic bent, no game about investigation can help itself but to make a reference to red herring. If somehow you don't know what a red herring is, red herring, it's literally just a phrase that means, like, an incorrect lead. Something that looks suspicious but isn't.
Bloody rare steaks went out to the evidence folder. Sparrison, remind me not to let you talk to clients on an empty stomach.
Come to think of it, I did find it a little strange that we weren't given any cutlery.
No cutlery? Even for the well, she's a cat.
Nope. You would think that would have been that the great Baron of Chateau would have gorgeous silverware, but there was none to be seen.
That was a little peculiar.
Is there anything else you wanted to know, Monsieur Falcon?
Who was there, Chappie?
M. Catalina, who attended the banquet. Well, there was me and my papa. My dearest Mammon.
My dearest Mammon couldn't make it. Mammon. That's got to be Mammon. That has to be Mammon.
Mammon. Couldn't make it. And there was Baron Rogil, who hosted the dinner, and his housemaid.
Coline?
I think she was called. Of course, there was Monsieur Grandoui. Well, until, you know, he died. And there was Monsieur Rubber de fucking Jesus.
Monsieur Rubitio de Robinet. Fucking. Ugh! French man! Okay. Robbie de Robbie.
The man with the camera. But he was only there for a little while. I think that was all. Was there anything else you wanted to ask?
What happened on the night of the murder?
Ooh, let me think. It was a Friday evening. Me and my papa had just arrived at that place, the home of the great Baron Rogil. Probably not pronounced like that. My papa spent all evening talking with Monsieur Grandoui and the Baron about business stuff. I'm a young cat and therefore I'm dumb.
Business stuff?
Well, three of them own a railway the three of them own a railway company together. So all through dinner they were talking about company shares and investments, but I didn't really understand most of it because I'm a cat and I'm a girl and it's fucking 1800s France and fucking women don't know any and apparently women knew nothing until like the mid 1900s.
It's a joke about the fact that women don't really come up in history that much compared to men. Even though they almost certainly shaped it quite a lot. Joke.
But after dinner, this man with the camera took our photograph. That was a lot more fun. We were standing there for half an hour because the exposure took fucking forever. Sorry, a man with a what took your what? It's turning into a rape case? Like, what the... Camera. It's a very new gadget. A tiny bug sits in a box with a tiny paintbrush and paints your picture very fast. Ah, no, I like the explanation. In 10 minutes, poof, you have a perfect picture. Wow, technology is amazing! I don't think the lady's explanation is right, Sparrow. No, let me fucking dream, Falcon! Pshaw, let me believe- Yeah, let us believe, you fucking prick! Still, the camera sounds like a very special device. I'll make note of it. We already had, haven't we? Please continue, Dame Cataline. So after we had the photograph, I went into the gardens to get some air, and that's when I found the body of Monsieur Grandouille! He was all ripped open. Exclamation point. A housemaid saw me standing over the froggy monsieur. Is it? It is still monsieur, isn't it? Not monsieur. Because I've heard some of you pronounce the N, but I'm pretty sure the N's silent. And called for help, and then the police arrived. Before I could say anything, I ended up here. It was such a blur. Must have been terrifying. It wasn't so bad. My papa taught me how to be a brave cat. Was there something else you wanted to ask, Monsieur Falcon? Nope, think that'll be all, madam. What's the plan now, Falcon? The way I see it, we have two tasks. We should head to that place to try to see the scene of the murder for ourselves, and we should try to track down the supposed photographer, Monsieur Robbie de Robbie. 2 days for two tasks seems doable. We should head back and get some rest first. We have a lot of work ahead of us. Wait, Monsieur Falcon, before you go, you do believe my story, don't you? I believe in justice. I believe that a fair trial can draw the truth from any situation. I believe in justice. That's good to hear. You're not wrong, Falcon. That's not what the lady needed to hear. Well, no, because I'm also not going to just decide I side with her. I can't remember how these trials turn out. And quite frankly, I probably don't know who was actually innocent or guilty in any of the trials in the game, because I kept fucking them up, so I've got no clue.
I don't know, work on being less of a, how to put it.
Could have said it in English, bud! Fil de pute?
I don't know. Serving justice makes me a...
that. Then I wear that title proudly.
Dame Cataline, Monsieur Grandouille, Baron Rogiel. These names are getting a bit confusing, aren't they?
Yes, they are! They really are. Not particularly. Well, fuck you two.
Well, it is for me. I'm going to start compiling a Facebook, or Facky book, so that I can keep track of who everyone is.
A what?
A Facebook! It's a collection of people's names, pictures, descriptions, in one easy-to-carry catalogue.
I think I understand. Name could use a little work, though. Sparrow's going to start compiling a Facebook. You can access a list of people you meet at any time. I think Quark's a jackdaw. Monsieur Grand... We haven't met Monsieur Grandouille! He's dead! Met Cataline. JJ Falcon. Sparrison. That guy. We also haven't met him, we just got a letter from him.
Make a move.
Game saves automatically at the start of each new day. But you can also make a quick save at any time by clicking save and clicking the pause menu. Pause menu by clicking on the yes, good. Right, well, game saved, and we're about half an hour in. Hopefully my stupid voices aren't too grating. But that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your moderator, so I think, and as always, keep calm, carry on, good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a terrible day when I made this video. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. All the same, if you're interested in seeing some live streaming stuff from me, if you look in the description, there'll be a link to my Twitch page, as well as a link to my Twitter in case you want to keep up with all the random gibberish I spew throughout the week. And if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always donate to my Patreon campaign, also linked in the description. Well, that's all from me. This video's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the sideways thinker. Do not seek the pardoner.